Welcome to this video. I want to talk about the new Harmony OS leaks and beta version that came out just a few days ago. And yeah, we want to dig into it, so let's get started. So we are talking about Harmony OS 2.0 beta version. Actually, I think it is version 3.0 already, the beta version. And it is available now for some developers in China, and they leaked some new specification, new UI changes as well, just like, for example, the UI that is available for the tablet. So for tablet users, you will clearly see that they will have a new UI that looks a little bit more iOS-y. So it looks like an iPad OS, like, and also on the phone, the same UI has been taken over from MIUI or iOS. So if you swipe down from the right corner, you will get all your quick toggles. If you swipe down from the left corner down, you will get the notification shade. So this is one of the biggest changes that you can see. And you have some other nice little changes, just like, for example, the icons on the desktop or on the home screen itself. They can be swiped upon. I think you can swipe up to see some widgets of the icons. That reminds me a bit of the BlackBerry Android version that also had this feature already. This looks a little bit more polished on Harmony OS. And in general, the UI looks a little bit like a combination of MIUI, iOS, and Emotion UI. So what Huawei had before. So it is still in this line of MIUI 12-ish, maybe. Harmony OS looks a lot like this. One of the most interesting thing is, and I was looking and watching, of course, looking at the comments that you wrote about my Harmony OS video so far, is that people are tending to see, okay, this is more like an Android fork and it's not really a new operating system. That might be not correctly and not really true. See my last video that I will link somewhere here in the corner, where you can take a look at this as well. So what we will see there is, I think, the microkernel of Harmony OS itself that is running in parallel to the Android kernel, or the Linux Android kernel, that is underneath there for hardware stuff. Because, of course, like I said before, Huawei has to depend on the vendor's drivers that mostly are Android drivers. So what you will get there are Android drivers that are only specific for this Linux kernel that Android uses. So they don't create new drivers for the Harmony OS microkernel. So what they do is they are using the Android kernel drivers, and the microkernel is sitting in parallel next to the Linux Android kernel and can be used for newer stuff, for Harmony OS stuff, for maybe communication with other Harmony OS devices itself. So this is one very interesting thing that I discovered, and I think it might be very, very interesting to share it with you. Also, there's a new boot animation. So if it boots up, you can see this little O logo for Harmony OS. So very, very nicely done, I think. So it's on a good way, I would say. It is testing right now in China. It will be a release, I think, in June or May. There will be a release already there, maybe also final release or an update out for people, for more people, public beta, for more people to test out. And then I think later this year we will see updates for the P40, for the Mate X2, and maybe even a P50 release with Harmony OS 2.0. This will be very, very cool, or even 3.0. That would be very, very cool if we have this. And then we can take a closer look into the system, dig into the system, how much Android is there still, how much new stuff is there included in Harmony OS. What do you think about this new technology? What do you think about this new operating system? What do you think about Huawei going this way? Write it down in the comment section. That's everything for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Until the next time. Bye.